Today we are going a little bit off topic and talking about scholarships. Last year I applied for KGSB scholarship and I got in, and today I'm making this video helping others to get in as well. But before that,
alright, so I gotta go Seoul and pick up the camera that I'm filming on right now, but it was broken, so never mind, just hang on. Why everybody trying to go, yeah, the party jumping off, and we putting on a show, trying to catch a vibe. We do this every time, like na 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 na. Feeling like I'm on the highway, 'cause everything been going my way, and now they looking at me sideways. I'm like na 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 na. This is where I wanna be, na na na. Never ever gonna leave.
Alright, so let's get it started. Well, I made myself kind of like bullet points here to help me, whatever. Well, first of all, what the hell KGSB is, right? Well, if you Google that, it's gonna say it's an academic scholarship funded and managed by blah blah blah. Long story short, it's just fully funded scholarship. It covers like bachelor's degrees, master's and PhDs. So for like bachelor's degrees, it's like 4 years degree and 1 year Korean language, which is like 5 years in total. And for master's, it's like 2 years degree and 1 year Korean language, which is like 3 years in total. And for PhDs, it's like 3 years degree and 1 year Korean language, which is like 4 years in total. Now, what are like the benefits, or like what does this scholarship covers? It pretty much covers everything. I mean, flight tickets, health insurance, tuition fees, monthly allowance, and for undergraduate students, they get like 900,000 Korean won, which is like this much US dollar, and for graduates, they get like 1 million Korean won, which is like this much US dollar. So it's pretty much enough money, right? So who can apply for this scholarship or like eligibility? So first of all, we have nationality. So your country has to be on the country's list guideline file, which I'm gonna link it down below, so check it out. And then age, you gotta be under 25 years old if you wanna apply for bachelor's degrees, and you gotta be under 40 years old if you wanna apply for master's and PhDs. Then GPA, you have to have like 80% or higher. And trust me, this is really important. If you have below 80%, you can apply, so just pay attention to that one. Finally, health. You just gotta be in a good health. So now, what universities are available for you to apply? So basically, they kind of like divide universities into like two types. I mean, like type A universities and type B. So type A universities, they are like the really top dog notch universities in Korea. I mean, like the top universities like Seoul National University or Korea University, SKK University, which is mine. And type B universities, they kind of like mid-range universities. I mean, like a little bit lower in ranking, but they're like still really good. So you just like have to choose type A and type B. And then what fields or like majors are available for you to choose? So it's basically you can choose whatever like the university offers. Like for example, if you want to apply for SKK University, you can choose whatever major or field SKK has to offer. You get me? So it depends on the university itself. Now, required documents. First of all, we have application form, which is like the scholarship application form, and you can download this file on the scholarship website, or I'm gonna link it down below so you can check it and fill it. And then we have personal statement and study plan, and those like really important documents. They're kind of like a bunch of questions, like personal statement, I believe like 4 or 5 questions. So you have to compose your answers in kind of like essay format, and the same applies to the study plan. So pay attention to them, and you have to write like really good essay, because it really matters here, your essay and your story. It has to be exciting and tempting. So just pay attention to it, and the same applies to study plan. Then we have recommendation letters. So you basically go to one of your high school teachers or like two of them, and then you ask them like to write recommendation letters for you. And after he writes the recommendation, I mean like the teacher, he has to seal it inside an envelope and then signs over the envelope itself. So it has to be sealed and nobody can open it. You get me? And this is really important. And if you want more information on how to get the recommendation letters, you have to read the guideline file, which I'm gonna link it down below, because it has like more detailed information on how to get the recommendation letters the correct way. Also, we have high school transcript. or like, you know, your just high school graduation certificate, you have to bring it. As we mentioned before, it has to be 80% or higher. Then proof of citizenship. So you just bring like whatever proof of citizenship you have, like passport, like whatever, just bring it, like document. Finally, we have awards in languages. Like for instance, if you have IELTS or like TOEFL or like other awards, just bring them along, because they're gonna boost your opportunity and just, you know, give you higher chances to get selected. Now, how to apply? So basically there are like two ways or like two tracks to apply. There's like the embassy track and university track. And for embassy track, you just take all of your documents to the embassy directly. And in case of university track, you just send your documents to the university you want to apply to. The only difference between embassy track and university track is that, like, when you apply through embassy track, you can basically choose three different universities. At least one type B has to be included. You get me? Like, you can choose two type A's, university, and one type B. But university track, you just choose one university. That's, you know, the only difference between embassy track and university track. So now, there are like three rounds or like three stages for you like to pass. So the first one is kind of like after you take all of your documents to the embassy or like you send them to the university, the first round starts. They're gonna screen and process all of your documents, and if you made it through the first round, they're gonna contact you or like call you for like interview. And the same applies to the university track. If you made it through the first round, they're gonna call you for like interview. And if you made it through the interview stage, the second round starts, where they send all of your documents here in Korea, and then they get screened and processed for the second time. For university track, it is really like just two rounds, the first one and the second round. So if you made it through the second round, congratulations, you just got selected. But for embassy track, it's kind of like three rounds. After the second round, if you made it through it, so the last one, they send all of your documents to the three universities you chose when you applied or like when you filled out the form. And each university, they're gonna screen and process your documents for the final stage or like the third time, okay? And if you made it through this stage, congratulations as well, you just got selected. And let's say you made it through the first round and the second round, but you failed on the third round. You just failed. Yeah, that's, you know, that's for embassy track, like the danger is there. But for university track, just like two rounds, the first one and the second one. Yeah, that's it. So if you made it through the third round or the last round, then you just can follow like the process, or like the embassy will guide you, or like the university will contact you and give you more information on like what's next. So it's kind of like easy process, and you don't have to worry about that one that much. So you just like you have to pass through rounds, like the first, the second, and the third. Okay. Finally, I want to talk about like deadlines. So this scholarship opens like every year. I mean, like for undergraduates, it opens like between like September to October, I believe. And for graduates, it opens like late February until like March. So yeah, those like the deadlines for this scholarship. It's kind of like every year scholarship or like annual scholarship. Finally, I want to touch on like restriction on applying to this scholarship. So if you like graduated like Korean high school or like finished a degree here in Korea, you can apply. Also, if you have like a criminal record, you can apply. If you got selected and then you withdrew the scholarship or like canceled the scholarship, also you can apply. And finally, if you apply to two tracks at the same time, you can apply to embassy track and university track at the same time. So you just gotta choose one track and apply for it. Yeah, so that was like completely walk through the scholarship process and how to apply and like what documents are required. But please don't just depend on the information on this video. You have to like to check the file yourself. I mean like the scholarship guideline file, because it has like really detailed information, so you can get like every single answer, and pretty much it's gonna like just answer all of your doubts. So please read that document if you wanna apply for this scholarship. Yeah, so I guess yeah, that's it for this video. That was really just like a short, you know, video on like the scholarship and like what is going on about this scholarship and like where you can start if you want to apply for this scholarship. Don't take this video too serious. I mean, like, you just have to check, as mentioned before, you have to check the application guideline yourself and get like really detailed info on this scholarship. So guys, that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching, and by the way, subscribe to the channel if you want to, you know, help me, and if you're like interested in life in Korea like that, because I already live here, so just, you know, subscribe. So thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to hit like, subscribe, and later.